Claremore, Oklahoma. Claremore is a city in the county seat of Rogers County in northeastern Oklahoma, United States. The population was 18,581 at the 2010 census, a 17.1% increase from 15,873 at the 2000 census. Located in the Ozark Mountains foothills, the city is part of the Tulsa metropolitan area and home to Rogers State University. It is best known as the birthplace and home of early 20th century entertainer Will Rogers. This area was part of the territory of the Osage, but they were forced out under a treaty with the United States. During the Indian removal period and until statehood, this area was a reserve of the Cherokee Nation, which had been removed from its territory in the southeast United States. This was within what was known as the Cherokee Kuiskawi District. Around 1802, bands of Osage Indians settled in this area of what is now northeastern Oklahoma. Black Dog was the chief of a band that settled at Pazona, where the city of Claremore later developed. He shared power with Chiefs Claremont, aka Claremore, and Pahuska. Claremont, named by French traders, settled with his band in a village known as Pasuga, meaning Big Cedar, which was located on an ancient platform earthwork mound in this area. The Osage village of Pasuga was destroyed by Cherokee in June 1817, during the Battle of Claremore Mound, also known as the Battle of the Strawberry Moon. These western Cherokee had moved into the region from the southeastern United States and were perpetually competing with the Osage, who looked down on them. At the time of the attack, most of the men were out of the villages to hunt bison on the plains. The Cherokee killed the men in the village, and took more than 100 women and children captive, selling them to Eastern Cherokee. Accounts differ as to whether Chief Claremont was killed in the raid. After the Indian Removal Act of 1830 was passed by Congress, this area was designated as part of Indian Territory and the Cherokee Nation were assigned much off this territory. Claremore and the Mound are within a part of the Kuiskawi District in the northwestern part of the Cherokee Nation. The Rogers family, for whom the county is named, were among the first European American settlers. Clem Rogers, father of the famous entertainer Will Rogers, moved to the county in 1856. He acquired lands for his Dog Iron Ranch that eventually consisted of more than the Clem Rogers home. Will Rogers' birthplace still stands outside Ulaga, and is considered an important historical site. Clem Rogers was a major advocate of Oklahoma statehood. He was the oldest delegate to the state's constitutional convention in 1907 at age 69. He and other members of his family were buried at the Will Rogers Memorial. A post office was established on June 25, 1874. The coming of railways to Indian Territory was the driving factor in Claremore's early growth. Two early lines intersected in the center of town. The town changed the spelling of its name from Claremont to Claremore on September 19, 1882. A clerk recording the town as having a post office had spelled the name incorrectly, and it stuck. The city was incorporated in the Cherokee Nation on May 2, 1903. Claremore's newspaper, the Claremore Daily Progress, was founded in 1893 by Cowboy Joe Klein and is still published daily. It is the oldest business in Rogers County. Claremore's growth was aided by the popularity of sulfur springs among Americans in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. They believed bathing in such springs to have medical benefits. George Eaton had settled with his family in the Claremore area in 1874, and conducted farming on cattle raising. He later branched into the mercantile business, real estate, and oil exploration. While drilling just east of Claremore in 1903, Easton struck an underground pool of water that smelled of sulfur. Local physician Dr. W. G. Williams tested the water and marketed it as a cure. Known as radium water, it contained no radium, but hydrogen sulfide and sulfur compounds that were believed to make it medically useful. Eaton built a bathhouse and promoted the pool area as Radium Town. Radium Town was centered on 9th Street between Seminole and Dorothy. Bathhouses were built by promoters all over this area of Claremore, and for a time attracted travelers and tourists for the waters. Only one was still standing as of 2008. Claremore's first hospital was established in the early 1900s along what is now known as Will Rogers Boulevard, or Oklahoma State Highway 20. The building is standing but has been abandoned and boarded up. The city has many historic homes and other buildings, with several located in the Old Business District. In 2002, Claremore received a grant from the state's Oklahoma Main Street program to redevelop its business district with improved urban design and enhancement of historic properties. Renovation work on the downtown was completed in 2007. The Rodgers and Hammerstein musical Oklahoma is set in Claremore in the surrounding area, in 1906, the year before Oklahoma became a state. The Quantum Leap TV series, episode 8.5 months, is also set near Claremore. The movie Where the Heart Is, starring Natalie Portman and Ashley Judd, fictionally portrays Rogers County and the area surrounding Claremore. Claremore is located at 36.315181-95.612784. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of which, of it is land, and of it, 1.96% is water. The city is located in Green Country, a popular nickname for northeast Oklahoma that stems from the region's green vegetation and relatively high amount of hills and lakes compared to central and western areas of Oklahoma. Claremore lies near the Verdigris River, with undulating terrain producing hills and valleys. The city's primary water sources are Claremore and Dooligal Lake, both within the drainage basin of the Verdigris River. Claremore is a major intersection of heavily traveled highways. Interstate 44 crosses the city to its southeast. State Highway 66, historic US 66, was designated along one of the main east-west roads of the city. Hetown. State Highway 88 and State Highway 20 intersect within the city limits. Two railroads, the St. Louis, Iron Mountain, and Southern Railway, now controlled by Union Pacific, and the St. Louis-San Francisco Railway, or Frisco, now controlled by BNSF, intersecting Claremore. The traffic problems resulting from the intersection of two major national rail lines has led to discussion among city officials about how best to improve traffic flow. As of 2007, the city plans to elevate the BNSF railroad throughout the entire town. As of the census of 2000, there were 15,873 people, 6,283 households, and 4,165 families residing in the city. The population density was 1,319.4 people per square mile, 509.4 per square kilometer. There were 6,784 housing units at an average density of 563.9 per square mile, 217.7 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the city was 75.69% white, 1.99% African American, 14.31% Native American, 0.44% Asian, 0.03% Pacific Islander, 1.12% from other races, and 6.42% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 3.02% of the population. There were 6,283 households, out of which 33.6% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 49.6% were married couples living together, 12.4% had a female householder with no husband present, and 33.7% were non-families. 29.7% of all households were made up of individuals, and 13.8% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.43 and the average family size was 3.02. In the city, the population was spread out, with 26.7% under the age of 18, 9.0% from 18 to 24, 27.6% from 25 to 44, 19.8% from 45 to 64, and 16.9% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 36 years. For every 100 females, there were 89.5 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 86.1 males. The median income for a household in the city was $34,547, and the median income for a family was $45,810. Males had a median income of $36,227 versus $21,742 for females. The per capita income for the city was $17,853. About 8.9% of families and 11.9% of the population were below the poverty line, including 15.4% of those under the age of 18 and 15.0% of those 65 and older. Claremore is home to the main campus of Rogers State University, which grants a master's degree and bachelor's and associate's degrees. The university serves more than 4,300 students. It is the only public four-year university in the Tulsa metropolitan area. Claremore is also home to Northeast Technology Center, a vocational training campus which serves over 200 students and offers both full-time and short-term classes. Public school districts serving Claremore are the Claremore Independent School District and Sequoia Public Schools, named for the Cherokee man who developed written Cherokee language in the early 19th century. SIST consists of Claremore High School, Will Rogers Junior High, Catalina Elementary, Westside Elementary, Claremont Elementary, Stuart Roos Elementary, and the Alternative Learning Center. Sequoia Public Schools consists of Sequoia High School, Sequoia Junior High School, and Sequoia Elementary School. The first school in the Claremore area was opened to students in 1870. Claremore's first major high school was built in 1919. It was the most expensive public school building in the state of Oklahoma at the time. The building was used as a school for almost 80 years, until 1999. The increasing costs of maintenance of the old building forced its closure. Claremore's economy is diversified. Baker Hughes, an oil field services company, has a large presence in the city. Together with several other large companies, it is located in Claremore Industrial Park. This is only a few miles from the Tulsa port of Catoosa, located on the Verdigris and Arkansas Rivers. Coal mining is also an important industry. Strip-style mines are operating on both the north and south sides of the town. Claremore has a popular website called moreclaremore.com, which focuses on positive community journalism. It was launched in April 2013 and focuses on community events, local businesses, people, and schools. It also features the central community calendar for the area. The site has an average 40,000 visitors per month and has an active social media presence, with more than 24,000 followers on Facebook. Claremore's daily newspaper, and one of the oldest ongoing businesses in the county, is the Claremore Daily Progress, first published as a weekly in 1892 and as a daily in 1893. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.